start question number 2. That is, what are decomposers and scavengers and how they are useful to us? So what is our topic? Today's lecture's topic, that is the long answers. So I am just writing, take out two notebooks so that you will be able also to write and complete on time with me. First the heading, that is long answer type questions. And after that, question number 2. What is the question number 2? I have already said you that it is, what are decomposers and scavengers and how are they useful to us? So let's start the question first. How are they useful to us? You already know about decomposers and scavengers. What are they? Usually we know scavengers are that type of animals, usually depend on the dead animals, isn't it? And decomposers are that type of organisms which just destroy and feed on the destroyed dead animals. They also help us to clean our environment. In what way? We are going to discuss in the answer. So let's start writing the answer. Some carnivores. Some carnivores and omnivores. Vultures. feed on and destroy dead animals. These organisms are called decomposers. These organisms are called decomposers. Fungi and bacteria are examples of decomposers. They clean our environment. We can say God also, like someone used to like chicken also. Yeah. So they are the sum, but we are going to describe only out of that three of them. So let's start the answer now. Honeybees. vitamins and minerals too. You know, honey is a sweet in taste. So we used to give some enhances to our food by just adding honey to it. So honey is also a sweet food. Vitamins. Clear? So for the large production of eggs, what happens? These hens are rare. For the large scale production, for today. I am on next lectures. We are going to deal with the other questions.